Welcome to 9th Maths Online Classes. In our previous video, we were learning about how to find the angles on the intersecting lines and we learned about two properties, that is linear pair and the vertically opposite angles. Now today's topic is finding the angles on the parallel lines and the name is parallel lines and a transversal. So let's start. Now first of all, what are parallel lines? Parallel lines are the lines which never intersect each other. That is, they are the opposite of intersecting lines. We have intersecting lines which cut each other and parallel lines are the lines which are never intersecting each other. Now, second is transversal. What is a transversal? Now, suppose there are two lines which are parallel to each other. That is, line L and line M. They are parallel to each other. What is the symbol of parallel? L parallel to M. Okay, these two vertical lines are the symbol of parallel. Okay, the line L and line M are parallel to each other and there is a third line which cuts both of them. Okay, this third line which cuts both of them, this is my line T, this is my transversal. Okay, two parallel lines are cut by the third line, that line will be our transversal. Now in this figure, we have many angles made on it. There are basically 8 angles. Angle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, we have 8 angles made on these two parallel lines cut by a transversal and these angles have basically 4 rules. Okay, there are 4 rules for these angles. The first one is corresponding, second alternate interior, then alternate exterior and then cointeria. Now coming to the first one, corresponding angles. Okay, now what are corresponding angles? The angles we have here, this angle 1 and this angle 5, they are corresponding angle, that is on the same side of the transversal and the same side of two parallel lines. So angle 1, angle 5. Okay, similarly 2 and 6, similarly 4 and 8 and then angle 3 and 7. These are my 4 pairs of corresponding angles. And the corresponding angles have the property that they are always equal to each other. That is, they are equal to each other. Okay? Now, second one is alternate interior angle. Now, first of all, what is interior? Interior angle means that if I have the parallel lines, the angles will be in the interior of these lines. That is in between these lines. Okay, and alternate means that on the opposite sides of transversal. What I am saying is that there are 4 angles in the interior of parallel line. Okay, these 4 angles are in the interior and they should be on the opposite sides of the transversal. That is, this, if I take this 4, then the alternate interior angle will be this 6. Okay, this is on the opposite side of transversal. If I take angle 3, this will be alternate angle to angle 5. So angle 4 and 6 and angle 5 and angle 3, they are alternate interior angle. And what the property is? The property is that they are also equal to each other. You can see that this shape, if I notice this shape, this, then this and this. What is this shape? This is the shape of Z. Right? This is like this. Whenever in the question we have two parallel lines and have a shape of Z, the Z can be like this, Z can be like this and it can be like very like this. Okay? Any shape in the form of two parallel lines and it is a little bit looking like a Z, in from any direction, then we will always apply the alternate interior angles. Now coming to the third one, alternate exterior angle. Now what are exterior angles? The angles which are made on the outer part of the parallel line. If I have two parallel lines and the angles which are made in this part and this part, which are not in between the parallel lines, they are exterior angle. And alternate again is on the opposite side of the transversal. So if I take my angle number 1, this is my exterior angle. What will be the alternate exterior angle of 1? It will be this 7. For this 2, it will be my this angle 8. So my angle 1, angle 7, angle 2 and angle 8. These are alternate exterior angle, and what is the property? Again, they are equal to each other. Now there is the last property, that is co-interior angles. Okay. Now what is this co? Co means consecutive interior angle. Interior angle means that is inside the portion of parallel lines, and consecutive means on the same side of transversal. Here we were taking the on the opposite side of transversal. Here we are taking on the same side. That means if I take angle 4, the co-interior angle will be angle 5. Okay? And if I take the angle 3, for a co-interior angle will be this 6. Now what is the property here? Now there is a change in the property. All these properties say that these angles are equal, but this property says that their sum will be equals to 1. Okay, so these are the properties which can be applied only on the parallel lines, and you need to remember what the rules are, that is which angles are equal and which angle sums to be 1. Now in this question, the previous known property, that is linear pair and vertically opposite angles, can also be used. How? Look at the figure. Okay, this is my figure, and if I ignore my this part, I'm ignoring this part. So you can see that these two lines are intersecting to each other, right? These, if I don't take this line, so these two lines will be intersecting. So on the intersecting lines, I can apply the two previous properties. Similarly, if I hide this part, I will have these two intersecting lines, and again I can apply the property. Okay? So basically, I can apply six properties here, but these four properties are of parallel lines, and the previous two properties are of the intersecting lines. Now let's take an example based on the parallel lines. Now in this question it is said that L is parallel to M and it is cut by a transversal T, and we need to find the all the angles when angle 1 is 70 degrees. Okay, only one angle, that is angle 1 equals to 70 degrees given, and we need to find all the other angles. And we have six rules we can apply, the two of the intersecting lines and four of the parallel lines. So you can apply any rule, and a particular question can be done in plenty of ways. Okay, in any question you can apply different rules. Okay, so what I am doing is, I have angle 1 as 70 degrees. So the easiest one is angle 1 equals to angle 3. Reason, vertically opposite angle. Okay, in this chapter we will always write the reason for everything. Okay, whenever we do like this, we will also write our reason, otherwise the marks will be deducted. So angle 1 equals to angle 3 by vertically opposite angle, so my angle 3 will be 70 degrees. Okay, now I know my angle 3 as 70 degrees. Now I can also find my angle 2. How? Angle 1 plus angle 2 equals to 180 degree. That is linear pair. So 70 plus angle 2 equals to 180 degrees. And angle 2 will be 180 minus 70. That is 110 degrees. Right? So my angle 2 will be 110 degrees. Then my angle 4 will also be 110 degrees. By vertically opposite angle. Now, since I have found all the angles on one line, I can easily find all the angles of other line by applying the rules of parallel line. Till now, I was applying the rule of intersecting lines. Now, I will apply the rule of parallel line. How? Angle 1 equals to angle 5 equals to 70 degree. These are corresponding angles. Similarly, angle 2 equals to angle 6, angle 3 equals to angle 7, angle 8 equals to angle 4. These are corresponding angles. So this is 110, this is 17, this is 110. I have applied corresponding angle property. You can apply other property also. I can say angle 4 and angle 6 are equal. Why? Because they are alternate interior angle. Again, I will get angle 6 as 110. From here also, I get one angle 6 as 110. So, it doesn't matter which property you are using. You should use it correctly. Okay? Similarly, if I find angle 6 with the help of this 3, I will get angle 3 plus angle 6 equals to 180 degree. This is 70 plus angle 6 equals to 180. So, angle 6 will be 110 degree. Now, which property I have used? I have used co-interior angles. So, I have found the value of 6 with the help of corresponding. Then, I told you how to find according to the alternate interior and then by the co-interior. The value is same for all the cases. It's up to you which thing strikes your mind first and you apply that rule. All the rules which we have learned today, such as corresponding, alternate interior, alternate exterior and co-interior, they can be applied only when the question says that the lines are parallel. If the question doesn't say that these lines are parallel, you cannot apply the properties. Okay? Now, there is an example which is the exact opposite of the previous example. In that question, the lines were given parallel and we need to find the angles. Now, in this question, the angles are given and we need to show that lines are parallel. And the lines can be parallel only when any of the four properties we learned today can be satisfied. You can prove any one property that is holding in the figure and you can say that lines are parallel. Now, this is the figure given to us. And we need to prove that L is parallel to M. But I can see that there is no relationship between this angle and this angle. We haven't studied about any angles which are like this. This angle and this angle. We haven't studied about that. But I can find any other angle with the help of this angle or with the help of this angle. So I can apply the other property. Okay? Now what I can do, I have plenty of ways of doing it. I am taking only one way. How? Suppose this is my x. Okay? So, x plus 75 equals to 180 degrees. So, x will be 180 minus 75. That is 105 degrees. Okay? So, 105 degrees. Now, I can see that my this angle and this angle are same. Okay, now let it be 1. I can say that x is equals to y. And which type of angle they will form? They will form alternate interior angles. Okay, they are alternate and interior angles. And if the alternate interior angles are equal, that means L is parallel to M. Okay, what I did, I find the other angle with the help of this 75 and said that these two angles are equal. They form alternate interior angle. You can write they form alternate interior angle. So, lines are parallel. You can do it in some other way also. With the help of this 105, I can also say that this is my 105 degree by vertically opposite angle. Then I can say that these two angles are corresponding angles. They are equal, so lines can be parallel. So any one of the four properties can be satisfied by you to prove the question. Now let's take an example based on the parallel lines. Now in this question, we have three parallel lines and one transversal. But in three parallel lines I can also apply these properties. Okay, now the question says that these lines are parallel. Y is to Z is 3 is to 7, find X. I need to find this end, right? But how will I find it? With the help of this thing. It is given to me that Y is to Z is equals to 3 is to 7. And whenever we have something in ratios, we take them as 3X and 7X, 2X and 5X, like that. But in this question, there is already a variable X. So, I will take something else in place of X. So, I can take Y equals to 3A and Z is equals to 7A. Okay? The variable should be same in both of them. Now, how will I find X? I can apply any property we have learned till now because the lines are parallel. Okay? Now, what can I do? I know that this is Z and this angle will be alternate interior angle, right? They are alternate interior angle if I take these two parallel lines and ignore this line, right? So this should also be Z. For now, let's suppose this is my W, okay? So Z will be equals to W by alternate interior angles. You can find some other angles with the help of other properties. You can also find this Y as this Y, vertically opposite angle, or anything which comes in your mind first, which seems easier to you, you can apply that one. Okay, I have applied the alternate interior angle. Okay, now I can see that W plus Y equals to 180 degree. Reason? Linear pair. I can also apply the property of intersecting lines. Now W is my Z plus Y equals to 180 degree. Now Z is 7A plus 3A equals to 180. So 10A is equals to 180. So A will be 18 degrees. Okay, I got the value of A, but I need Y and Z. Y is 3 into 18. Z is 7 into 18. Okay. Now what is 3 into 18? This is my 54. And this is my 126. Right? Y is my 54. Z is my 126. Now I need to find the value of X. And the value of X can be found in plenty of ways. There are many ways of finding the value of X. The first way I can see very clearly is X plus Y equals to 180. Reason? Co-interior angles. This is X plus 54 equals to 180. So X will be 180 minus 54. That is 126 degree. This is one way of doing it. Now let's see what can be the other way. Okay, the other way can be X equals to W corresponding angles. Okay, if I don't take this Y, don't look at this, X and W are my corresponding angles. So they should be equal. And what is the value of W? W is equals to Z and Z was my 126. So, X is equals to 126 degree. Okay? This is the second way of doing it. Now, what can be the third way? And it is quite the simplest one. How? Ignore this line. Ignore the line CD. And you can see that X and Z, these angles are alternate interior. So, X equals to Z equals to 126 degree. These are alternate interior angles. Okay, so you can apply any of the method from these three and you can make some other method by yourself also. Because there are a lot of way of doing this question and I have told you three here in front of you and you can apply any other way also. But one thing remains same in the question that you have to apply this because I need to find the value of A. Then Y and Z to find the value of X. So these are the questions. questions which can be asked on the basis of parallel lines and transversal. So I hope you understand today's topic. Keep practicing and thank you.